Hello, Frenzy. My name is Kate Shark, and welcome to Life is Strange Before the Storm. Now, I actually was not planning on playing this game for the simple fact that this is one of those games I feel like every YouTuber and their damn dog has played. But, obviously, I was actually watching Jack Septiceye's playthrough of this, and at least the first episode, I haven't completed it. Or completed watching his. But, and there was a lot of things that happened that kind of really hit home for me, especially within this past year. So I wanted to play this and kind of give my two cents on some situations. So I thought it would be a fun game to play. I don't remember what's going on with everything, so it's been a while since I've watched it. But I will go. But I thought I'd be able to bring something, some commentary to the game. I don't know. Don't ask. Anyway, so I'm gonna not waste any more time, and we will go ahead and begin the episode. Oh, yeah, because we have all three already. Okay, so now, quick fact, these episodes are long. I think they're like 3 hours each, so I'm gonna try to keep these minimal. So what will happen is, I'm gonna break them up into two parts. So it'll be like episode one, part one, and it'll be like an hour and a half, and episode one, part two. Another hour and a half. So it'll be like Mondays and Fridays, part one, part two, if that makes sense. My brain's a weird thing to be in half the time, but I'm gonna go ahead and we're gonna start this. Oh, did I not start? Okay. And if you're not familiar, these games are player choice where your decisions affect. I'm not sure how badly they affect, but they do. And it's very teenage angsty, so be prepared. Let's all revisit our childhoods, why don't we, huh? Pretty jerky move. Punk.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
I forgot to turn it off.
Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
Mom. Okay. I forgot to turn off the subtitles. Move the camera. Yeah. Oh, here we go.
No trespassing? No way.
So push sprint, hold down this, press S to jump it. Oh, I see, okay. Fuck you, sign!
Holy shit. This place is awesome.
Dope. Okay.
If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
Okay, those of us who are legit, don't say we're legit.
Do yourself a favor and scram.
I'll be throwing my shit. I paid good money on that fake. Oi, knock it off.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
Let's try talking to him. I'm not gonna... That's so weird.
God. Again? What do you want, kid?
The mill, your bike. I mean, your bike's pretty fucking awesome. I gotta admit.
Is that your bike over there?
Don't be a dick about it.
Yep. It's, pretty cool.
It is, I'll admit.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Okay, you started a backtalk challenge. Oh, shit. Okay.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
In backtalk, you use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want, okay?
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager?
It fucking sucks!
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
I don't have a bedtime? To succeed, pay attention to what your opponent says. Okay, bedtime. Your bedtime, no bedtime. Do me a solid.
I don't sleep. It's for the weak.
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Cute. Okay. What could it hurt? I don't do cute. Cute is relative.
Kittens riding tiny mopeds are cute. I'm more like Red Sonia riding a panzer tank.
You got like 6 more feet before you're Red Sonia, sweetheart.
I get it. You're tough.
Sometimes the right choices are difficult to pick out. Here, playground is a good response to kid.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
Okay.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
Girl like me, girls kick ass. I'm not worried.
Girls
kick ass.
Girls kick ass, you idiot. I can take care of myself.
My boss will kill me if I let you in.
Bosses suck.
Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for
hey,
answer,
hey.
Are you?
Nope. But I'll give it.
You really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
Okay.
This is intense! Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Delia?
Cute dog.
Scream, don't touch my soul with dirty hands! Oh.
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
Thrash! Dope, Deerhead.
Can you talk louder, please?
Hey, drunk girl. Your hair's pretty awesome. Let's see. No. Well, well, well. Looks like my kind of party. How do I get in? Is it over here? Fuck off. Oh.
Here we go.
Oh, shit.
Fuck.
You okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't. Now I got pushed by the mosh pit. Dude.
Nope. Don't You're care dope. Either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
Slut.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine.
Okay, go.
Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
Okay.
Hey.
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm trying to see this damn band. But this place is crazy packed. Hard to get to the stage.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha! The internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Ah, yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon who?
Yeah.
This is his place. He's a friend of mine.
Where do those stairs go?
Up.
Up?
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? We're gonna rot it all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine.
So let's hang out in the place and have a concert.
I'll see you later.
Yeah, I'm not gonna try to buy weed off him. And I know that guy, the t-shirt vendor, you can steal a shirt. And I'm not gonna do that, just for the simple fact that it's pointless, and that's how bands make their money. I mean, don't steal shit. That's how they make their money. Let them... The drummer's tank top there. Someone loves to write fuck off everywhere.
You spilled my beer, bitch!
Hold on.
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
I don't want to insult the guy. Just walk away.
We're not done.
I may not want to insult the dude.
I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough.
Fine, I guess we'll stick with an insult.
How about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude. She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
You guys, I'm pick gonna up teach on, this pick on a teenage girl.
I'm serious. You wanna
We're
see me get angry here?
Grown men.
Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty.
You won't like me when I'm angry.
She thinks she can take you?
Whoa, that's intense.
Hey, dickhead.
I guess attack? Ah! Oh, yeah, let's get away. Oh, shit.
Rachel? Come on!
Okay.
Hurry up!
Yeah, let's not look back. You just go.
Let me go, Frank! Not gonna happen. Calm down. Come on, man! Walk away. Screw this! Get the fuck out of here!
Okay. Never been in a concert where you're like mosh pitting like that. Although I am going to see, I've seen them by now by the time this airs, but I'm going to see Nine Inch Nails at the end of September. So that'll be fun. Oh my. Filthy habit. It's one thing I never picked up. Okay, I like this music. Okay, I'm not gonna wait around for this.
Sometimes all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the
daily rituals are important. Even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Max, the loser. Oh, Max is like the one. Put your thoughts in me. Okay. Dad got me the stationery one day. About wanting to send an email and the internet was down, and tonight I thought, hey, maybe it's time to write Max. Funny thing is, I don't really know what to say because we haven't talked in 3 months despite all my calls and texts, and not that I'm upset or anything. Fuck, there's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe the unfriended. Sad. Let's see. Oh, okay. Cool. Okay, so let's exit.
Oh. Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Wakey, eggs and bakey. I love eggs and
bakey. Last night, seeing Firewalk live. The skeevy assholes. That girl.
You mean Rachel? I mean, you knew her name.
Is that really Rachel Amber?
Yeah. Rachel Amber sounds like a porn star's name.
Smoke cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Mystery Sharky, yes! Okay, let's change clothes then. Let's see. Oh, is that all I have? Okay.
Terrible news, my fellow Oregonians.
Got a nap.
Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab is shutting its doors. Might have something to do with all the health and safety violations they've suffered this year. We've had a near-death experience either day, but it's not.
It was pretty cool. I didn't really have any other options, so.
I really should get going.
Okay, I know you can find other stuff and all that. Mr. Sharky, let's look at Sharky.
Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb.
They do.
Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
They do indeed.
Shit, where's my phone? It's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Super drunk, dude.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it.
Okay, let's get the phone. Mom!
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
That is a pretty cool shirt. I'll give her that.
Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby.
Oh, here it is.
There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Will you be coming home at some point tonight, Chloe? Will you be home by curfew? There will be consequences. You'll have consequences. I don't know what that means. Okay. Oh, Elliot. Do this. What's this? You finished the chem homework? Nope. Do this a third time. I already know everything. So, funny thing about chem homework. When I was in chemistry in high school, I had this teacher, and I can't even remember her name, but she had you do your homework. And you turned it in into this folder and she just created it and gave it back to you. But she only checked to make sure you attempted to do it. She didn't care if it was right or anything. So I noticed that and I checked, like one time I didn't know the answer to something. So in an answer I wrote, I don't know. And when I got my homework back, it was counted as 100 as completed that I had done the homework. So there we go. I ended up actually making like a 96, I think, on the final at the end of the year. But I remember doing that and thinking, how do you know we're learning anything? Okay, that was just my little high school chem story.
Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
You think I saw Mom's purse in her room?
Good times in high school, let's see. Oh, Mom!
Mom! I don't know that David comes here for dinner.
I mean, I'm glad you're using protection, Mom, but damn.
I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad. What's the matter, Mom? You don't want Dad to see your new boyfriend?
Okay, I'm gonna place it on the dresser, because you shouldn't hide pictures of a happy memory of a spouse, even if they have passed and you...
You don't deserve it's a happy to be memory. Stuck in a drawer like this.
Yeah. If your new boyfriend or whatever can't get over the fact that you're... That you had a life before them, I mean, I'm not saying put up pictures of your ex, but it's not as though you broke up on bad bad circumstances or anything, the person died, and you have a...
Breakfast.
Well, you want your damn bag, Mom!
Mom, when I was, like, 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed.
Oh, shit. Where's your damn bag, Mom? Oh, there it is.
No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Right? Like, that's what every teenager wants to hear. Oh, left.
Coming,
left
mom.
Mom. Anyway. But yeah, I don't. If your spouse or whatever, partner, whoever dies, I think it's okay to have pictures up of them still, even if you have a new boyfriend or girlfriend or whatever.
Put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dope. Wait, are we having bacon and eggs?
Dining eggs table, here I come.
Put the purse down. Here you go, Mom.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I just put it down.
See what Mom wants before she strokes out.
Yep. Breakfast!
It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
Bite your tongue. Eat it now while you can, before you have to start worrying about cholesterol.
You want to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
I was sleeping.
I was sleeping. I didn't get your text until just now.
Oh, you make it so hard to trust you.
It's a teenager.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
David's your boyfriend. Let's just...
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole. Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
Who's joking, Mom? Sorry.
It's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
Come on, your mom made that for us.
The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What? I was sleeping.
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that?
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what
my
you're
rule
doing.
For life.
Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Yeah, I mean...
Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Shit.
Maybe you're 16 and don't know what you need. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
He should, he's not my father.
It's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
David was a good man. David's an asshole.
friend's an asshole.
He's been good for me. Maybe he rubs you the wrong way because you've been rude.
Rude.
He's still breathing. That means I've been more than fair.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
Lame.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
You know what? Let's be understanding. Pick our battles.
Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
It is. Don't ever let them lie to you.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's nice.
Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too. Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
Oh shit. There we go. Newspaper. Let's see if it says anything special.
Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the app. Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. Okay, I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
We're already supporting one. Thanks.
Okay, that's not entirely fair. I'm married to a vet, so... They don't have it easy, trust me. They do not.
Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one.
That's sad. Weinstein. Up until recently, I've never had to deal with, like, step-parents or anything.
There
I don't...
they are.
Oh, I don't have a step-parent as of right now, and my parents have, like, just separated within
the
last...
Let's get these to David so he can drive away. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. They better get going.
My parents just separated, like, this year, and I haven't had to deal with step-parents or anything like that, which I'm very, very, okay. I have your DVD, you can get it before school, thanks. Is that it? Okay. But luckily I haven't had to deal with step-parents or anything like that. I know some people are very close with their step-parents, although there is a possibility I may have some kind of parent who's seeing someone that I am not crazy about, and I have made it very clear that I am not supportive of it. So I can see where she's coming from. When there's someone your parent is seeing that you absolutely hate, it's not an easy thing to do.
The car, too.
And to be fair, it's not easy having to tell your parent, like, I don't like this person you're with. It fucking sucks.
To get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us.
Right? Why does it have to be women?
No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Exactly.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
Yes.
I do, actually.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something?
Car repair guides, toolbox. I don't want him using my father's tools, that's for sure. He's got his own damn toolbox. Ow! Damn cat! Oh wait, wrong way.
50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
Let's see what we've got here, just to look.
Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore?
Yes, you just have to know where to look. Box of Dad's stuff. Hold on, let me push.
Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache.
Yeah, you're no Doc Holliday, dude. What's this? I don't give a shit. Okay. David! Here's your socket wrench.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you.
Hey, I was pretty fucking quick. It's a big fucking pigeon on the roof.
See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
I'm already good at it.
That's what makes me special, David.
All right.
Except fist pump, leave him hanging. I'm gonna do it just for.
Fine, whatever.
Just to say I did. I tried. I can't say I didn't try. Try to keep the peace. Pick your battles. Pick your battles.
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
That's true, it does.
But thanks.
And someone who knows how to use them. Don't laugh at my dad's toolbox, you dick.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
We
right?
Don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So
whoa.
There are some things I want to be real clear about.
Shut this down, ignore and endure. I really don't feel like getting in an argument, so I'm just gonna ignore.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's all you
Joyce,
gotta do.
Your mother. She's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough.
Stop.
No doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes sense to me?
Just say got it and move on.
Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
There's no point arguing about it. One thing I learned from my teenage years, pick your battles.
Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you. What a beautiful day. This isn't right. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Dad, turn it up.
Actually, not a big country music fan. Buckle your seatbelt. My lover from the grocery store. Whoa! Damn! That's intense.
You're gonna be late.
It's a nicer way to wake up for the kid, okay? Thanks.
Shit.
I mean,
thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying.
I see everything.
I see this!
Hello, Black Hell.
The Tempest. Drugs, they will mess you up. Okay. I mean, they're not great. Alright, come on then. Yeah. The Bigfoots? Is that our mascot?
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
Who exactly is talking shit about me?
You know. Haters on social media.
Great. I wish I could tell everyone to just get a life.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you wanna go together tomorrow?
It's gonna be lame. Say maybe.
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
It's actually in a play in high school my senior year. It wasn't anything like The Tempest, but...
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Oh, wait. What's this? Wait, hold on. What did I do? Oh, fine. Hey, I'm at the picnic tables with Mikey. Thanks. On my way. Cool. Seems still down. Back. Yeah, here we go. Come on. Damn it! Let's see what it says. Get DVD from Steph. It's an interesting way to put the objectives down. I had a friend in high school named Mikey, too. Speak.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
You're right, I wouldn't. Try me, I used to play. I've actually never played a tabletop game. My sister and her husband, my brother-in-law, play like a weekly game, and they're really into it. But I'm gonna say try me, at least we'll see.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Heard of them. Have never done one, but...
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics.
Classics,
you even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel is a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just, like, a friend thing?
I mean...
Why do you want to know?
Yeah, right?
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah. I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
It's 20 minutes before class? Why not? Let's give it a shot.
Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
I'm totally an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know. I'm good. All right. Let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elima, Wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named,
Barb. Barb. Calamista, I guess.
Calamastia.
Calamastia, excuse me.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
What's made a man kebab? according to my character sheet... I'm gonna go with the character sheet.
It says right here that I taught your precious King Tiberius everything he knows about fighting. So, Elamon, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
You gave her that, elf barbarian.
I did.
Elamon bows deeply. I've heard of you in the castle. King Tiberius owes you his life. It's an honor to fight alongside you.
Damn straight.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the Raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgeron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The Raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie.
Why is it my choice? Okay,
where do you wish to go?
I say to the training ground, because there's
good
loot. Yeah.
Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Oh. Knee slam, pommel strike. Let's say... I don't know.
I do a pommel strike. I strike his pommel hard. What did I say?
A pommel is the end of a sword handle. Oh. Pommel strike is where you hit the guy with it.
Ah, damn it. Okay, I do that.
Except you're not wielding a sword, you're wielding an axe.
Well, then why was it an option?
It's all right. Try using your...
You've delayed too long. The orc swings his warhammer at your head. Barely missing. Your move.
Let's say Fatal Cleave.
Okay. Let's end this. Fatal Cleave.
Go to chemistry class.
Raid axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game.
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survives.
Dang.
I mean, we all make mistakes.
Don't worry, Elamon guy. We all make mistakes.
Elamon nods. Calamastia, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
For now.
What's next?
Fuck up again. Let's try the prison
camp. Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages. Each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
We can intimidate him, but I don't... Tempt with bread?
Apparently, I have bread. I try to tempt the little bastard out with it.
He sticks out his tongue, finding your offering disgusting.
Ugh.
Okay, let's try to pick
it
the lock.
It says here I can pick locks. Can I do that?
Sure. You spend a long time trying to pick the lock, but don't accomplish anything. The dragonkin makes an obscene gesture at what you can only assume are his genitals.
Shit.
Okay.
LOL.
Intimidate.
Okay, you can
That's
just
a
laugh.
Skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't-
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use-
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Meat puppet dragons are pussies, shoes. I don't know, meat puppet?
I wiggle my hand. Hey, dragonkin guy. Want to become my meat puppet? How it works is I shove my arm up your ass, into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Neither do I.
The dragonkin pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one. But I cannot give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
Could make
you're
you taller?
Short, I say. But I could fix that. I'll just cut off your head and wear it as a top hat. Then you'd be way taller.
The dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Wow.
That was nuts.
I'm going to give you a plus 10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then, it dies of fear.
Awesome.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
I guess
tent time.
Warlord's
tent? You enter the tent to find Durgaron. Warlord of the Raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except
what
about the acid?
For, you know, acid blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
Brutal Punch, Wrathful Rush, let's say, Wrathful Rush?
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry, angry shoulder slam.
Okay.
Dope.
I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
I want to punch that stupid man cow in the dick.
Like, right in the dick?
Right in the dick!
Right in the dick.
You miss.
Oh, fuck. He missed his dick.
As you stumble past him.
Asshole.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage.
Ouch.
What do you do next?
Kiss.
Holy shit! Annihilation strike.
That sounds boss as fuck.
One?
That's bad, right? Not
for me. It ain't good.
As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, three.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg.
Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
I am so sorry.
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
Dance? I would say...
I jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean,
it's fictitious,
thanks,
so what's it matter?
Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
Swing for his head, why not?
One last swing at Durface's head.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Oh no.
I'm dead anyway, so...
11. You swing, catching Durgaron on the side of his head, severing one horn. But you don't do enough damage to kill him.
What an asshole!
He laughs, then rips you off his sword with a vicious jerk. You die painfully.
So yeah. Mean.
I'm sorry, Chloe. I have to escape.
Hey, man. If you can, do it.
I cast Warden's Hideaway.
You sure?
It's all I've got.
You summon a spectral door, which shields you from Durgaron. Light flares out, blinding him. The door swings shut, then disappears. You are gone from sight and cannot be harmed.
I guess I'll have to come back when I'm stronger.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
You just drew that now?
Sorry I died and left you out there to fend for yourself.
It's cool. I'll get him. Eventually.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class.
Joy.
Okay.
Got here, Twitch.
Don't call me that.
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh wow, this is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours. Give it back.
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Take it elsewhere. You're both losers.
Nice. No need to fight. You can both be losers.
Right.
The mute speaks?
I'm not mute.
Whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition.
Whoa,
how much
that's
financially does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow.
dick move, Nathan?
I can't help you.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop. Chloe, do something. Don't just stand there watching.
Step in.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Leave. Now.
You're actually standing up for Nathan Prescott?
Congrats. You've actually got me feeling sorry for Arcadia Bay's most spoiled brat. That's how much of an asshole you're being right now.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
I'm crazy.
You have no idea how crazy I am. Keep pushing and find out.
You want a piece of this?
Piece of cake.
Please. Kicking your ass is going to be a piece of cake.
You think this is funny? You think I'm joking here?
Think? That's a fancy word for you, Drew. Careful with it.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat.
You shut the fuck up.
Go, Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
You're welcome.
I mean, you did, so.
Are you all right? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
No problem, Skip.
Glad we talked. Me too. I know you're doing your best. Love you. Okay. I don't give a shit. Let's go ahead and go in. So we go to. Hello.
Oh, good. You're here.
I mean, at school.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda, indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Calm Keaton, down. It's high school
sorry
drama.
Sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective.
Oh, fuck.
The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
I don't know, I never read The Tempest. I would say Miranda's an idiot, personally. I would never say it's true love, especially when Shakespeare is involved. I had a huge debate with my father once on Romeo and Juliet. I'm gonna say Miranda's an idiot.
Miranda's an idiot because falling in love is stupid. What is she, 12?
I don't think falling in love is stupid.
Actually, she's about 15. So your point, whoever you are, about being an idiot or being naive is well taken.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Your eye looks fabulous. Where'd you get it done?
What?
Just kidding. That asshole really clocked you.
It wasn't a big deal.
He didn't do that bad. I just barely had it.
So, why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah. Sure.
Ow.
Okay. Get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down. Rachel looks so happy here. There's Rachel's belt. Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now. Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes!
Naked. Oh, I guess I could have thrown it over. Yeah, don't say nothing.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks.
Like even better out
so,
of it. Oh!
Did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
I guess I owe you.
I'll hold you to that.
I don't pick up my tickles at all. I'm getting them big time now.
I'll let you finish changing now.
And quit ogling you.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber.
It's my name.
Last night was amazing.
Firewalk was pretty good.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Maybe it doesn't?
Maybe it doesn't have to end.
Exactly. How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
I mean, let's
ditch class. You mean it?
Is that weird?
No, it's awesome.
I hoped you'd say that. Now about that eye, that is a hell of
Stop.
A scar. Do you want me to cover it up with some makeup?
What's it? Why not?
Yes, please. People won't shut
up. It's not even that bad.
Hold still.
You don't argue when a pretty girl's touching you.
This is a lot of makeup.
That's the price of valor. Close your eyes. Much better.
Holy shit.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Okay. Alright, so I am going to leave this episode off here. I've been playing for just about an hour and a half now. I think this is close to the halfway point of this episode. So like I said, I'm going to leave this episode off here, and I will come back probably right after this and finish up the episode, and then go from there. But in the meantime, thank you all so much for watching this first part of the episode. Be sure to jump down on that like button if you did like it. Leave a comment down below with any other game suggestions or video ideas that you'd like to see from me. Share this channel with your friends and subscribe to the channel if you have not done so already to see other videos that I've done. We'll see you all for the next one.